So the pros are coming up with new techniques in Fortnite all the time. I mean, it feels like there's an insane new clip every week showcasing a brand new technique that can revolutionize your Fortnite career. You know, Fortnite has one of the most highly adapted pro scenes in the world of esports. You know, with every season bringing in new and different features, and the pros just seem to know how to use them instantly. But your crunch time, I'm so excited, because today we're going to be showcasing 5 awesome new techniques that the pros use that you probably don't, and how you can incorporate these tips into your Fortnite matches and sessions. Are you guys ready for this? I know I am. Let's get this going. So if you follow all these pro tips, but you still can't quite rank up the way that you want to, all right, you should definitely head on over to ProGuides.com. Okay, we have master courses from the best pros on the planet that's going to teach you everything from the fundamentals to exactly what they do to be so good. I mean, it really is the best way to learn everything that you need to know about Fortnite in the quickest amount of time. So when you're all boxed up, you might fall into the bad habit of thinking that you're safe. Well, this new technique opens up closed boxes to peace control, even if the player trying to crack the box doesn't bother breaking down a wall first. And this new technique is surprisingly effective and will most definitely throw off your opponents every now and then for sure. So technically, this technique is like a glitch that Epic still hasn't gotten around to removing. But, you know, since so many different pros like Noah Ray Lee do it on a regular basis, I doubt anyone is ever going to be punished for it. So to do this technique, your opponent has to be in a box without a cone or a ramp on the inside, all right? So you want to place a cone on the outside of one of the walls and edit one box, which is along the side of the wall. And so you can then go underneath the cone and just easily phase a ramp or a cone through the wall. Your opponent is going to be so confused that they probably won't even know what hit them. So like from here, and I mean like right here, you can just try to take one of their walls or predict their movement and just try to piece control box them before they can even see it coming. And at first, doing this might definitely feel slow and clunky, but you know, when you eventually start to learn exactly how the movement and placement of the technique works, oh my goodness, it's going to be second nature, guys, and you're gonna be the ultimate peace control warrior in no time. In a recent Fortnite patch, Epic gave content creators and some competitive players the ability to host 50 plays competitive in games in creative lobbies. So not many people knew about this when it first came out, and it pretty much went under the radar for a while. But recently, competitive players and streamers in particular have started playing in them a lot more, really just to practice their in-game mechanics and skills. And so the reason these have grown so much more popular than regular 16 player creative in games is because it's just so much more realistic to them. The lag in these lobbies is insane, and half the time you can't even build properly, but that's kind of what makes it so similar to the real competitive in games. 50 players in one in-game is an insanely stacked lobby, which can really give you guys some extremely hard scenarios to really prepare yourself for a variety of different situations. I mean, it's basically what happens in the in-game of every top-tier tournament match, so being able to practice them at any time is something that gives these pros a serious advantage. You know, fighting somebody in a box fight is going to be so much harder when you know there are going to be dozens of other players looking out to third party. Even just having basic awareness in these matches is 10 times harder because all you're going to hear is constant gunfire and footsteps just blasting in your ears coming from all directions. Now I know, like, it probably doesn't sound very fun, but I'm telling you, putting yourself in these uncomfortable and frustrating positions is really what improves you and really just makes you a better player overall. And let me ask you this, like, have you ever heard the saying, no pain, no gain? Well, that's basically what you need to remember if you're trying to, you know, play in one of these lobbies. It's supposed to be hectic. You know, it's supposed to be stressful, and really it's supposed to really stretch your abilities to their absolute max. And this is how you grow. This is how you get better. It's by putting yourself in these uncomfortable situations. Unfortunately, players themselves can actually create lobbies for 50 player in games yet. So if you want to play in these lobbies, there are tons of discords that you can join and content creators out there who are hosting these for their community every day. All right, so this technique has so many benefits to taking advantage of when used correctly, and it can cover your back. I mean, it can conserve materials, and once you have it down, it can be used in almost any situation from box fighting to rotations. Let's say that you're in a box trying to heal up and someone is just W-King your wall. All you have to do is just turn in the direction opposite to where the enemy is and place a ramp so they are both behind and underneath it. And from there, you can just rebox or even tunnel away from them. So it's highly important, guys, that you always move directly opposite from the wall your enemy is pressuring. Otherwise, there's a good chance that you may get piece controlled if you go to the right or left. Another scenario in which you can use this ramp technique is when you're rotating to the zone, right? And there is somebody who might just spray you on high ground. Okay, just keep placing ramps so that you're always below them. And so the reason it is just so useful is because you don't lose any momentum or speed, and you don't use nearly as many materials as full-on tarping. And so as we said before, guys, like with every season Fortnite adds, they bring in new and different features, adapting to the pro scene again and again. And if you aren't constantly adapting and really taking advantage of these changes, you will not see yourself at the top spot anytime soon. And honestly, that's the truth. You know I love you guys, and that's why I keep it real. In Season 6, Epic introduced a brand new crafting system, as well as reiterating on the NPC system that was introduced back in Season 5. Okay, so there are now brand new ways to upgrade your weapons so that you can just become a terrifying threat pretty much as soon as you drop into the island. So the first thing that you gotta remember, man, in Season 6 is that, you know, there are now fewer NPCs that can actually upgrade your weapons for gold. And so there are currently like only 6 characters that can really upgrade your weapons for gold on the Fortnite Island. Jonesy the First, Bandolette, Dummy, The Reaper, Remedy, and Jules. But if you manage to combine one of these characters, a makeshift shotgun, and the new crafting system, you could just grab a purple pump like pretty much every time. Like, all you need to do is find a makeshift shotgun, upgrade it once or twice with one of the NPCs that we've mentioned still do upgrades, and then upgrade your weapon again with the crafting system. And it, you know, it's basically a guaranteed purple pump or primal shotgun every time with hardly any risk. There is one more slightly riskier way to just walk away with the guaranteed purple pump in Season 6. Okay, if you drop down near Der Burger, you're going to find the NPC Gut Bomb. Challenge him to a duel and win, and you're going to walk away with the purple pump just like that. So utilizing these new systems can really put you in a better spot and really give you an edge over your enemies, giving you a higher chance of getting that victory royale. So make sure, guys, that you're not missing out. Close range combat is all the rage in Fortnite Season 6. 2/3 of the weapons in the game no longer have first shot accuracy bonuses, so the focus has been pushed even further into playstyles like box fighting. And so as a result, one of the techniques that is really starting to take off in Fortnite is pre-firing. This is when you shoot your weapon at your enemy when you think that they're about to make an edit or try to deal damage on you without actually seeing them do it. So mastering this technique is going to allow you to deal huge amounts of damage to an enemy player before they can even have a chance to react, or in some cases, like before they even see you. It can be a major turning point in any fight, and especially, you know, if your enemy is just playing cocky because they think that they have an advantage. So if you're really able to really time your pre-files perfectly, you're gonna be able to deal major damage to your enemies just as they complete their edit, allowing you guys to really catch them off guard with a sneaky elimination, or allowing you to then go for a different wall or even disengage from the fight entirely if you don't think it's worth taking. You can officially practice your pre-file skills, you know, in a creative game with, you know, some of your friends. Pre-firing is like more about feeling than an actual skill, right? So you just need to keep trying it, and eventually, man, you're gonna start landing your pre-fire shots more and more. You can do it, and as I always say, I'm your number one fan. I believe in you guys, and you know, you gotta believe in yourself though. You know, stop talking negative about yourself when you run into trouble. When sometimes you get on your losing streaks and it just seems like, man, you just cannot win. Like, get into situations, maybe you like you're in the top three and then you get nervous. I've been there. I'm actually still there all the time. But you know what? Because we're human and you have to fight through it, and you just have to believe in yourself. And so believe in yourself, stay in the moment, stay grinding, never quit. That's my motivational moment for you. Bunch of crunch on me. Okay, so not everybody can become a top tier Fortnite pro. That's true. That's real. There's just not enough space at the top. But don't let that fool you into you thinking that you can't make it, because you can do anything you put your mind to, guys. If you guys can believe in yourself, right? If you guys can never quit, never surrender. Just because someone says that you can't do it doesn't mean that you give up on your dreams. So keep going. Hey, if you guys like the video, subscribe to the channel. And if you want even more motivation, connect with me on my Instagram at Your Motivation Guy. Keep grinding, never quit. I'll see you soon.